My name is Dosu Joseph, MONX International. Welcome to my exclusive interview on Tragon TV. Started from Iwaya, that's Onike. Born into a family of six, four boys, two girls. My elder brother David Dosu is also a goalkeeper. Kept for the Flying Eagles Youth Fund and he kept for Raka Rovers in Kano, Savannah Bank, host of Otaigu. Then my immediate brother again, Abbas too, once a goalkeeper, but he moved away from football. And today he's a professor. Then I follow, also a goalkeeper. So every one of us in there were goalkeepers, including my junior brother, John Dosu. Kept for 3SC, Bayelsa, Aqua United, and so on. I started from Iwaya, as I said earlier, kept for Onike Bombers. And from there, I went to Niger Lost Football Club, Ikeja, where we won all the competition in Ikeja, Division 3 to Division 1, 2 to Division 1. We won all the trophy and we got promoted. The most important competition played in Ikeja called Manufacturers Cup. We won it from beginning to the end. I think I made my name there and I represent Igbobi College when it comes to Principals Cup competition. We won the Principals Cup and from there I was invited to Lagos State Academica, where we also won the Academicals Cup and the Adebajo Cup too. And there, I met Joe Eriko, who gave me the platform, invited me to Julius Baja Feeders team. Played a season in Julius Baja and I left Julius Baja to Plateau United in Jos in 1990. Played a season with Plateau United, came back to Julius Baja, and I played 5 seasons with Julius Baja. Won the FA Cup, won the league, represent Lagos State and Nigeria. Then the competition was called Sekuturi Cup, not the Champions League we call it now. And from there, I moved to Europe and I was invited to the U23 team. My first salary was with Niger Lux. I think I was paid 70 kobo if I'm right, or 7 naira. But it goes a long way. That money we were able to buy what we call cut and sew. We were able to buy maybe video. We were able to buy provisions. And we still kept a little for transportation and so on. But the first salary I earned was in Julius Baja 1991. That was 1,000 naira. That was what the late Chief Idama gave me and he said, take, as for your signing on fee. But the amazing thing there is, B2, a car was sold for 2,500. And where the 504 was sold for 5,000 naira. We kept on struggling, saving and say, yes, we want to buy this, buy that. The more you keep saving, the more you're going there to eat the money without getting the target. And then someone just said, you don't save to buy car. You don't save to buy anything. The money will come and you will use it. I think I enjoy my youth, no matter how the pay was then. I was able to use it for one or two things, but I don't envy the present players, even though if they earn millions. Whatever we earn there looks like millions too, but what you use it for is what is important. Go home, relax and watch Nollywood. Then if there is football, I watch football. rice, plantain, stew and fish with water. Atlanta 96 was a great one for every one of us, the players, Nigeria and also Africa as a whole, because we are the first set that won the Olympic gold medal for Africa before Cameroon did it. I think we started from Nigeria here playing a friendly game against Togo, which we lost by 3-1. But because we lost to Togo, Nigerians were not happy that we should play the friendly game again before we leave. And the Federation organized a game between the U23 and 3SC Football Club of Ibadan. It was a good game for me because I was in goal in that game and I did very, very well. And after the game, Bonfred Joe came to me and he said, if I should perform like this again in any of our games in America, I might be in the team. And we traveled to Tallahassee to prepare for the champ competition himself, which is the Olympic. And we played a series of friendly games. The first game we played against Saudi Arabia, I had an injury. I wanted to go out, but Sunday Olisa told me I should try and continue. I kept on going, but after first half, I decided to go out. And I went out of the game. After the game, we got to the hotel. And Bonfred Joe came to our room and he said, Sunday, I have a goalkeeper that can only keep 45 minutes. I think I've called the minister and the FA chairman to send me a goalkeeper from Nigeria so that you can go home because you have an injury. We laughed over it. And I said, instead of staying without training, I need to go out there and manage the injury. And our first game was against Hungary. We won 1-0. I know a lot of Nigerians were surprised when they sees me in goal, because I think they were expecting Barua or Babayaro. But then we're all working for the same purpose. We're representing our country, Nigeria. In the second game against Japan, we won 2-0. Against Brazil, it was a very good game for me because there was a lot of pressure from the players, Bebeto, Ronaldo, and so on and so forth. But we lost by 1-0. We qualified. We moved forward to play Mexico. A good game too, we won 2-0. And there come again, almighty Brazil. We were down 3-1 first half. Second half, we thought it was all over. 15 minutes to go. The magic of Ikpeba for the second goal. The king himself, Kanu Nwankwo, make it 3-3. Thinking that was still the end. And we went on a golden goal, which is the extra time. And we break the jeans by beating Brazil 4-3. And there, we believe we can make Africa and Nigeria proud. And in the final against Argentina, which wasn't an easy one, we were 1-0 down against star-studded Argentina team, Ortega, Crespo, Zanetti, and so on. We were able to beat them too. And before we know it, the gold medal is already in Nigeria. Being supported by the Americans, And we appreciate them after the game. We wanted to be Americans forever, but then we need to go back to our own country and rejoice with our people, with their prayers and their support that kept us going. I think the game that made us was against Brazil, which nobody believed we could come back from 3-1 to 4-3. Not even our own play alone, I think with Nigerian players, prayers supporting us from behind. And we're able to break the Brazilian team. Well, I told him several times in training that the way you're playing your penalty, you're exposing yourself, the goalkeeper will surely know where you want to put it. Several times we bet. At times I win, at times he does. But then penalty can be taken by anybody. The best penalty taker can lose it. But that very day we needed that penalty. But the moment he lost it, I look at the clock again and said, it is finished. But the long throwing came again from from JJ Okocha himself. And Fatusi tried to kick the ball into the net, miskick a little bit, turned to a pass to Nwankwo Kanu, who raised the ball away from goalkeeper Dida, and he put the ball into the net. And there, it was celebration all the way. We couldn't look back and say, how come from 3-1 to 3-3? It was beautiful to come back from behind on 3-3 with almighty Brazil. Well, I'll tell you little about the atmosphere. About the juju, I know nothing about that. I don't know if it existed when I was there, but people talked about it. But during my time in the U23 and the Super Eagles, I think we're like one family. I exchanged my gloves with Ikesho Rumu, with Barua, with Babanyaro. Anytime we exchange, because the purpose of why we're there, we're representing the country, green, white, green Nigeria. But I tell you, in training, I think it's always, everybody wants to play. When you see us in training, I think you will see the determination in us because we want to make name. Winning the Olympic gold medalist, I think, opened doors for a lot of Nigerian players. I think we see Kanu moving from Ajax to Inter. You see Taribo moving on from Auxerre to Inter. You see Sunday moving from his Liège team to another team. Babangida from... A lot of things happened when we were in camp. In training, everybody wants to wear that jersey. But the most funniest part is between Okocha and Victor Ipewa. I think I can remember vividly. Victor normally had a plaster on his nose. That is when the plaster newly came out. And once you put that plaster, you won't get tired. And Okocha asked him one day, why did you put this plaster on your nose? He said, so when I take on the opponent, I won't get tired. Then Okocha said, will you play? You are not starting now. You know, and Victor got angry and said, are you the coach? Why did you tell me I won't play? And you won't play. Can we play in your position? So you won't play, you know. And there, I think it was fun. And in training too, you see Olise and Okocha quarreling too. Okocha won the ball all the time. He wants to dribble. And you see Olise telling him, hey, if you want to dribble, move the ball forward. And Okocha will tell him, Nigeria knows me as a dribbler. Nigeria knows you as a marker. Let me dribble. If I lose the ball, you get the ball and give it back to me. So I think we have quarrels, they settle, we behave like family. But in times of the juju issue, I don't think it existed when we were in camp. Every player in that team did their best. We contributed our own quota. I can't really pick one player that is the best, but then every player did what they're supposed to do. The defenders did their job, the midfielders did their job, the strikers scored goals. Is it Omokachi, is it Kanu, is it Victor Ikpeba, is it Amunike? They all wrote their names in goal when it comes to goal scoring opportunities, which they gave to Nigeria. I think everything, even those that sat on the bench, contributed their own quota to the game. Even the chairman himself, which is Sani Toro, though he didn't play, but we saw him every goal we score, he's always standing up and jumping up. I think every officials, players, I think contributed to the success of that team. Well, I met Sunday when we were in school. He played for Methodist Boys High School while I played for Igbobi College. That's where we met with his elder brother, Churchill Olise. Churchill Olise was the goalkeeper, while Olise was the captain of the team. So we played against Methodist Boys. We defeated them by 2-1. Olise Sunday was the one that scored the only goal. And since then, we became friends. When I went to Julius Baja, when I was invited to, he was there too. So we did the screening together. He was choosing to the main team while I was taken to the junior team. So since then, we became friends. Anytime he's going home to first half, we always go together, stay in his house, come back in the afternoon to Julius Baja, Euro 65 for afternoon training. So I've known Sunday from beginning, and I think he is and still remained up to date my best friend. We were friends without taking anything away from them. We just up to date, we call each other to say hi, hi. Ike is one of them. I was with Benga Okunawa, Motiu Adepoju some days ago. Up to date, we still remain friends. Anytime we see, we talk to each other, we call ourselves on phone and ask about our families, how everybody is doing. I think we're doing fine when it comes to friendship. My relationship with him was like a coach and a player, because he is an experienced man. He tells you what you want. If you can obey and abide by these rules, I think he will love you more. When he says do this, you do it. When he says don't, I think you'll be on his other side. But for Bonfrey Joe, I think from then till now, I will still say yes, he is one of the best Nigerian coaches that has ever handled the national team. I think every one of them are leaving a legacy behind. Before Bonfrey Joe, we have West Half, who did very, very well when he was around. US 94 was Nigerian's success story when it comes to football. Then Bonfrey Joe came in and he gave 96 a good one. And this time around, we're having a new coach on ground who has also qualified Nigeria for the World Cup. How far we go in the World Cup will show if he's one of the best coaches in Nigeria too. But for now, he's done well for himself. But the championship is what is important. He has done a good job by getting the players ready, still trying to get one or two players into the team. But I think those two has done well. When we're talking of coaches that have done well in Nigeria, West Half and Bonfrey Joe. Yes, Rua is trying to also make a name, but World Cup will surely judge. But for the qualification, he's done so very, very well. We've had the two, and the two of them has also done well. The foreign coach has taken us to LAC 16, which is the second round. And the home-based coach has also done that, which is Late Keshi. So I think the two are doing very well. It's everything in football. Everything. You want to go to the World Cup and play in the highest competition. Like every player wants to play in the Champions League when it comes to club football. Champions League is the highest. A lot of great players did not play in the Champions League final, neither in the World Cup. If you play in the World Cup, I think as a player, you have achieved whatever you want to achieve in life. Either you win it, either you just participate in it. I think World Cup is the in thing as a footballer. I'll tell you, I was at the World Cup. Because France 98, I was there live and direct, not as a player, but as a supporter or as a fan to cheer Nigeria to victory. So there, when I was in Italy, that was what came to my mind. I said, yes, I fought for the qualification. And if I can't be there as a player, I think I should be there as a fan. And I took it upon myself, called my agent, Churchill Olise, who took me to Europe then. And we went to France to watch. I was happy I was there. And after the championship, I said to myself, I've accomplished my aim. If I'm not there as a player, I am there as a fan. Well, I was driving on Ikorodu Road and I saw cows. I tried dodging to avoid, and then I lost the control. But what came into my mouth was Jesus. I was with a police officer Saturday, just two of us in the car. Also the rumor that I was with ladies in the car. I was with Saturday is a police officer. And when I had the accident, I called his name. Saturday, are you okay? He said, yes. I said, I am not okay. And I dragged myself away from the road on the pavement. And there he tried stopping cars to help. And luckily, an in-house person was passing, which is Taribo's car and his friends, but Taribo was not there. And they were the one that took me to a hospital. I don't believe that there is voodoo in football, because I grew up through Joe Errico, who knows everything about football, and who taught a lot of Nigerian players that have coached the national team football too. So it's all about your fitness and your belief. As I said, accident happened in a twinkle of an eye. It has happened. I don't have to look back and say, this is what happened, this is what happened. All I need to do is to look forward and pick my pieces, which I have done. So in times of juju, as you said, I don't think we had it when we were in camp. And I don't think anybody has been accused of juju. But if it truly existed, I would say maybe juju gave us the Olympic gold medal. Accident happened in a twinkle of an eye. But when it is a car, the first thing people say is, was drunk. But if an aeroplane had an accident, what they look for is the black box. So I believe accident happened in a twinkle of an eye. The most important thing is get the fact right before you judge that person. I don't drink, I don't smoke. But it happens. Important thing is, yes, I'm alive and I'm able to pick my pieces and forge ahead. A lot of things were said, and I kept telling people, go back to the Echo hospital and ask the doctor, the matrons. They have the record there. The moment I got to the hospital, the matron smelled my mouth, and I replied that immediately, I don't smoke and I don't drink. So the record is still there. As I said earlier, accident happened in a twinkle of an eye. Well, in a championship, you don't say how far I want to go. You pick the games one after the other. Our first game is important. If we win the first game, that means we have opportunity of qualifying. If we win the second game, that means we are there already. I can tell you we will get to this stage. But our first game in that championship, which is Russia 2018 World Cup, is very, very important. We win it, we're already in a good map or in a good preparation, but we lose it or we draw, we put more tension on ourselves. We've been to the second round, but if we get to the quarterfinal stage, I think it won't be easy with any opponent we're going to meet, because if we get to that quarterfinal, which is last eight, the players will surely want to die there. So last eight, if we get there, I think it's a good one. But I believe these young players can do better if they can be disciplined, determination, and be dedicated to what they want to achieve in Russia. My favorite player in this current Super Eagles team, I think, Moses is doing very, very well. Who will be the same? The two central back, Balogun and Leon, doing very, very well. I think I'll go for Victor Moses. Anytime he plays for Nigeria, I think we see his contribution and he always come out top. If I am the coach of the team, but in this case I'm not the coach, so it will be difficult for me to pick a goalkeeper and say yes, it will be in goal. Like I said earlier during this interview, I think we are all representing our country for just one purpose, to win the championship. So any one of those goalkeepers that are called to be in goal will surely want to do Nigerian proud. So I believe in three or four of them, whoever is called will surely go in there and do the best. I can't say that name or this name should be in goal. The coaches will do that. But for me, I think any one of them can make Nigerian proud. I would have loved to start with Dosu Joseph in goal, but Dosu Joseph cannot see himself. People will surely judge Dosu Joseph himself. I'm like a lizard, you know, when a lizard fall from tree, he looks left and right and he praises himself. But I will start from Ingo Rigogo as the best goalkeeper ever in Nigeria. And if I have to go to the left back position, we have great players yesteryears. I think I'll pick the one that played my number three, Celestine Babayan. If I have to go to rifle back, we have a lot of them in Nigeria. I think I'll pick Olayombo, if I'm right. And if I have to go to the central, I watch him play a little, I'll pick Chairman Christian Chukwu. And if I have to pick the person to peer him, I'll pick the boss, the gentleman himself, late Stephen Keshi. If I have to go to defensive midfield, even though if it's my friend, Sunday Olise, but I'll still pick Mudashiru Lawal. If I have to go to the right wing position, which is called number seven, then I'll pick Segun Adegbami. If I have to go to the midfield, as number 10 position, number 8. I will give number 8 to late Samuel Okparaji. If I have to pick my number 10, great player he was. The Nigerians still ask that same question. Who is the best among the two, Okocha or Etim? If I have to give the two of them name, I would say Okocha Etim. But I'll pick JJ. It's unfortunate he didn't win the African best player. That is the best. Not just African player. He should have been a joint world best player. But maybe because he was an Africa or Nigeria, he couldn't. Then let's go to the outside left. I think we have a lot of them. I think I'll pick Amizimaka Aloysius, though he played from the right side, but you can shift him from the other side too. Great player he was. I think I should leave the number 9 for Nigerians to judge. I think we all know him. Can't take it away from him. Even in death, he's still leading the ghost charts. Late Rashidi Yekini. Was fortunate to play with him before he retired. I admired him when he's on the pitch. Gentle, good shot on his left and right. Great header of the ball. I think a lot of people might say yes or no, but as for Dosu Joseph, that's my Nigerian best. I'll go with Rashidi Yekini. I'll go with late Stephen Keshe. That's a difficult one. But as I said, I'll go with JJ Okocha. I'll pick Nwobi. I'll go with Maradona. I'll go with Ronaldo. I'm not a fan of the two, but I'll pick Real Madrid. Neymar. Alex Ferguson. Pep Guardiola. Wizkid. Davido. Davido. These are great legends. I'll go for Bob Marley. You just mentioned it already. Sonny Ade. If you go back and watch Olympic 96, I always have a chain with my cross. Even though if we're going to the field and I forget the chain at the hotel or home, I have to go back because I'm not yet complete. I still believe in the cross, that whatever I'm doing on that pose, I am with a savior. So, my chain. I think it's only football that you don't have retirement. Every other job, there is pension. So in football, there is no pension. So I believe as a footballer, whatever you earn as a player, I think you should be able to try as much as you can to save. We all know that playing football from beginning to the end is not an easy one. But I tell you, what footballers go through after retirement is not an easy one. I don't know if it is the same thing with doctor, pilots, teachers, and so on. But for footballers, after retirement is not an easy one. If the government can come to our aid, fine. But if not, I think the footballers will surely try and take care of themselves. If you can see the present players now, they try as much as they can to make sure they have land properties, house properties, and so on and so forth. So that when they retire, they have something to fall back on. But then you can't say the same with yesteryear's players. I think, if the government, as I said, can come to their aid, it will be fine. But for the present one, I think they're doing very, very well. So I can't say more than that. Yes, I think we're being promised, the Lagos State government promises the indigene of a two-bedroom flat, which was given. They also promised a plot of land in Lekki, which was given. And the federal government promises an MON and a million naira, which was given. So I think it is. And I'll use this opportunity to say thank you to Lagos State Governor then, Colonel Buba Marua. When I had my accident, he was there to assist. He paid the hospital bill in Israel, Tallahassee, all through and my rehabilitation center. And I also say a big thank you to Fashola when he was also there as governor. And I also say a big thank you to number one now, which is Governor Ambode, for doing a very good job. I left football at a tender age, the age of 23. When I was trying to pick up my career, that was when I had my accident. And since then, I think I've been running an academy called Crystal Soccer Academy, later changed to Westerlo Football Academy. I think the academy has produced a lot of players to Europe and also to the Nigerian national team. As an Olympian, I've also produced an Olympic medalist, maybe not in gold. We had Dele Adeleye, we have Ambrose Van Zekin, we have Ajilore, we have Olufemi Oladapo. Grassroots football is important, not just in Nigeria, in all associations in the world. If you throw grassroots football away, I think you threw away the culture of football. A lot of the yesteryear footballers were picked during sports festival, Principal's Cup, SMC Cup, and so on and so forth. Not just in football alone, in boxing and athletics. But this time around, I think Principal Cup just came back, and that fight has gone. I can't really say, but I know, I think it's been sponsored by a bank. I think grassroots football is suffering. Attention needs to be shifting to it so that Nigerian football can go back to where it was. If you look at our national team today, I don't think most of those guys in the national team played in Nigerian league. And that tells you that grassroots football is important. Either they played in Nigeria grassroots before they travel, or they are European-born Nigerian citizens playing in a big club in Europe and being invited down to the national team. We need to make use of the advantage of grassroots football, because that is where you will get the U17, U20, before they will now represent the national team in U23 and the Super Eagles. Henry Wosu will speak at the age of 17. Keshi the same, Samson Siasia, a lot of them like that. Likewise, the young generations now. But grassroots football is important in football. Thank you for watching my interview on Trigon TV.